G'day, 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 you absolute bunch of bloody legends. I hope you're doing fantastically well. So it's 40 degrees outside in Australia. I've got the air conditioning cranked up all the way. That's why I'm sitting here in a sweater. You might ask, what's happened? You know, loser bum, what has happened to your normally beautiful face? Well, what you might say is actually, hey, loser bum, you're bloody awesome. And I'll say, yeah, I know. Please tell me more about that. And then you might say, hey, loser bum, you're the greatest. And I said, yep, I know. Please say some more. And then you will ask, loser bum, what happened to your face? So, very simple, drop bear attack, right? So, for those of you who don't know Australia very well, we have a thing called drop bear. So, it's basically a type of koala, but see, just Google it and you get pictures, but it's one which is meat-eating. Normally, koalas eat eucalyptus leaves. These ones also eat meat. And the problem with them is when they fight during the mating season, the males fight in the trees during the mating season, and then they fall out and fall on people's heads. Multiple people in Australia are killed every year by drop bears during drop bear mating season. And that's what happened. Got hit by one with my lightning fast reflexes. I did a ninja back fist and like whacked him out of the tree, but he got a good swipe there in my face. But it's not that bad. We'll have that fixed pretty well soon. I have to go get myself checked for chlamydia, because all drop bears and all koalas have chlamydia. Speaking of burning sensations, the topic for today is actually burning. Did you notice that? Yeah, that's called a segue. I might do another video on segue. Burning, we're asking about screen burning. So what happened was, one of my super fans, Lo, shout out to Lo, he's one of my super fans. He recently got attacked by a drop bear as well, also got a scratch over his eye. I think on his, it's on the other side actually. But that's neither here nor there. So I was checking some internet, and because I only had 400 terabytes a second internet speed, I had to go and check what was wrong. And I just dropped into the Windows command line, right? This, you might not know this, but yeah, this is the Windows command line. And this is a place where you can do ping. It's good to know the IPv4 address of Google is a server which will always answer your ping. This is Google's DNS server, 8888. And yep, see, so there is my absolutely fantastic. That's an error here. It should actually say nanoseconds here, but because I've got such awesome internet, but it displays it wrongly as milliseconds. So yeah, and Lo, my fan who was looking at my shoulder, said, hey, why are these kinds of things, the command line, or where in Unix you're in the shell or telnet? Soon we're going to do a video about telnet and MUDs. Look out for that. Why are they always white on black? Right, this is the only Windows you see where the text is white and the back of the screen is black, whereas on everything else, on your browser, on your text editor and everything, it's the other way around. It's black or maybe blue on a white background. Now, it's a very valid question, and it goes back to the days of early computing, and it's not that long ago, but today we're used to having so-called graphical user interface. What you have, you know, every computer you have today, it's got a mouse, you have multiple windows, it's very graphical. However, when computers started, it was text only. This is what computers would look like. They would talk to you in text and you would write back in text, and that's how it worked. And incidentally, don't be fooled. Just because you've got all these pretty pictures and YouTubes and your TikToks and all that, what you've got out there underneath, the reality is every computer still has stuff like this. The entire internet, Google, the actual servers which are doing Google and YouTube, when you set them up, when you control them, you're very often in a screen like this. It's the dark monochrome world. It's just black and white. This is where real stuff happens. It's not pleasant, but it's very, very productive. And that's what all computers used to be like. Now, going back to those early days of computers, we didn't have the nice sort of here flat screens and LED screens and plasmas or whatever. The screens were actually CRTs. CRT stands for cathode ray tube. So if I Google CRT, always Google, you could do an image search. Actually, we'll do an image search. Let's see if we grab this guy. No, we'll grab it up. Well, let's be nice. Let's support Wikipedia. I give them 100 euros every year or so. I mean, 100 Australian dollars every year. And here we have a picture of a CRT. Before we do that, this is what they kind of look like. If we do Google image search, remember to always do Google image search. Big, big box. They see that big thing at the back. It's not a flat screen like today. And when the front is a little bit curved, that's how you know you've got a CRT monitor. Maybe one day I'll drag one out of the rubbish and see if I can fire it up, because there's some funky stuff you can do with CRTs and magnets and whatever. Anyway, back to the thing, not pictures. This time we are going to the Wikipedia article. Those screens are cathode ray tubes. That's how it works. And fundamentally, what it looks like, or what's happening, is inside the this glass tube, it's not really a tube, it's more of a cone. It has to be glass because there's a vacuum in there. It's been sucked out until it's a hard vacuum, not quite as hard as space, but there's reasons for that. Maybe I'll explain that some other time. Anyway, you have the vacuum inside this glass tube. You have a heater here and a cathode. A cathode just means a negatively charged plate, so it's minus. And because it's minus, it means there's a lot of electrons. Then here you have you have the electrons coming out, and they're being accelerated into a beam towards the screen. So it's one line of electrons which are shooting at the screen. Now, that's cool because electrons are negatively charged particles. You can accelerate them using magnetic fields, and you can also deflect them. So here on these deflectors, just like on my Millennium Falcon, they're different kind of deflectors. But here, the electrons, because they're charged, you can pull them in one direction or in the other. So you can steer where that electron beam is going. So that's cool because then you can steer it to places on the screen, and by switching it on and off, you can then, that's how you build up a picture. That's how all televisions, how all monitors used to work. Now, there's a problem with this, is that electrons are invisible. They're all around you. You've got trillions and trillions of them in your body. Every atom has got a certain number of electrons flying around them, but they're invisible. So what's the point? They hit the screen, they're pointed at you, they're not going to hurt you, but you can't see them. So the screens have to have a certain chemical or a certain stuff on the inside of the glass, which when it's hit by the electron beam, then it lights up, right? So that's why it's called a fluorescent screen, right? So again, we have electron beam, we have the deflecting coils who are controlling, is it going left, right, up, down? We have the the fluorescent screen, which hits when the electron hits, that makes a white or whatever color dot, and when the electron is off, it's just black, and that's how we make screens, and that's how all screens used to be. Now, what does this have to do with the command line and these things being white on black? Well, all these old screens were like this, and imagine, yep, electron beams pointing at my face. It's writing these little letters here in pixels by switching on the electron beam at exactly these, and where it's black, it's switched off, etc. Now, the problem is that fluorescent screen there on the right, and if I go back, it was often made with phosphor. For instance, various types of phosphor, because they were that was a good fluorescent medium. The problem is they didn't have an unlimited life. So every time it hit and lit up and made a white pixel, it would lose a tiny little bit of its power. Not a lot, right? I mean, TVs can last for 10, 20 years or 30, but over time it degrades, so it's not as good as before. So again, what does this have to do with burn-in? So there's an effect called burn-in when you leave the same picture on a CRT monitor, an old-style CRT monitor, for a really, really long time. The places where the pixels are activated will start to fade, and the picture will then be burnt in to the monitor. Hence, burn-in, CRT burn-in sensation. So that's how we get, and it's a perfect example. You Google it, and if you find a Google image search, you actually wind up with, on this Reddit screen, where's a perfect example. This is a Pac-Man arcade machine. You know Pac-Man there in the background? That's one of me playing the perfect game, 3.3 million points. Crikey, that was long, like 5.5 hours to play that. But yeah, you have to do things. But anyway, because Pac-Man, it was only showing, that's the big arcade machine, was only showing one maze. The maze was always the same. and you can see how the maize has literally been burnt into the screen. And that's why we talk about burning, and that's why on old computer monitors they would mostly like to leave it black and only light up the pixels that you want to minimize burning, to minimize the wear and tear on your screen, make sure that it lasts longer. All right, that was it. That was the video today. Look for some more white on black text in some upcoming videos. Going to have some cool stuff around Telnet MUDs, but maybe I'll get sidetracked and talk about segues and things like that as well. Anyway, I hope you enjoyed the video. Remember to like, share, and subscribe. Remember to tell your friends to like, share, and subscribe. You're all a bunch of bloody lesbians. I'm Loserbum, you're the internet, and I am out of here.